Hello, bonjour, comment ça va? Today we're talking about how you can use virtual desktop without any internet connection whatsoever. Let's dive in. Welcome back to VR Essentials, where we talk about the practical uses of VR. Last week I uploaded a video about the update of virtual desktop, but rightly so, you guys highlighted that I forgot to mention that you can actually use virtual desktop without any internet connection whatsoever. So here we go. If you want to find out how to install virtual desktop, go to the description below the like button, as last week I uploaded a video about the updated installation process. To run virtual desktop without any internet whatsoever, here's what you're going to need. First of all, you're going to need a router and also an Ethernet cable. Now, all you have to do is plug in one end of your Ethernet cable into your router and then the other end into your computer. And boom, you will have what's called a private network that is only accessible within your own home. Then all you have to do is open up your app streamer or virtual desktop on your PC and open the app inside of your Oculus Quest. You'll see at the top the speed of your Wi-Fi, also your IP address, and then it will automatically basically connect to your PC as it would in any other instance. Then go to the games tab, you'll see all the various different games in the Oculus section and also the Steam section. Now, if you're gonna open up a game from Steam, do know that on your PC you might have a pop-up that comes up and make sure that you select offline mode. Now, what you need to know is that if you're not gonna run virtual desktop with the internet on, there will be some VR experiences that will be affected. For example, when I was using Google Earth, well, it principally needs the internet in order to render all the different maps. So as you can see, when I was in Brazil, it was absolutely fine because the map had already pre-rendered. But then when I went into Manhattan, the landscape just wasn't there. It was just inexistent, and that's because the internet was required. Virtual desktop do recommend that you do use an Ethernet cable in either case, whether you will be using apps connected to the internet or not, simply because it's supposed to provide you a faster connection, since virtual desktop does not require the internet connection to work by its own. For most of the VR experiences that I tested, it was actually the same whether I had the Ethernet cable or not put inside of my router when running virtual desktop, which means that when I was standing next to my router in the same room as my router with no walls and no doors in between, I always had a really good experience. There was no issue whatsoever, and frankly, I was really happy about that. But then the moment I plugged in the Ethernet cable and I went back into my studio, which is about 15 meters away with a wall and a door in between, well, unfortunately, I get a lot of stuttering and it just doesn't really work for me. I need to use the Oculus Link. Virtual desktop also recommend that you open up any VR experiences from the games tab. However, there are some apps that might not work. For example, VR Tennis doesn't work. I have to go into Steam VR Home and then open it from there. Also, do be mindful that of course you'll be running the offline version of Steam. So when you go into Steam VR's Home, you'll see that you won't be able to see any thumbnail of any of the games whatsoever. However, if you mouse over them, you can still see the name in text, so you'll know which game to choose. Now, do be mindful also that when you're playing really, really huge games, perhaps like Skyrim or, for example, Half-Life Alyx, it does require some time for the game to cache inside of your computer. So when you're going to run it, especially for the very first time as a fresh install or fresh game, then it might stutter here and there no matter where you are placed in relation from you to your router. Thank you for watching today's video. You're awesome. Remember to hit the like and subscribe. Share some love so that you and I together we can grow the community and help as many people in virtual reality, because at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. Until next time, take it easy. And as always, DJ, take it away.